For 10, Fame of Jamaica. If you had to choose just a handful of famous names to represent your nation, would you include the athlete known for his incredible speed? Maybe the freedom-fighting musician that favored peace, happiness, and marijuana? How about the bombastic reggae fusion singer? Usain Bolt, Bob Marley, and Shaggy aside, there are many notable names that hail from Jamaica, including proponent of the Pan-Africanism movement, Marcus Garvey, folklorist and writer, Louise Bennett Coverley, or Miss Lou. One of the top five fastest female sprinters, Shelly Ann Fraser-Pryce, and retired basketball Hall of Famer Patrick Ewing. And who can overlook football stars like Rolando Ahrens and Raheem Sterling? For those seeking a taste of some Jamaican YouTubers, be sure to check out the soccer-centric Javier Nathaniel, Yacht Boys, and Acom Entertainment. Number 9. Cuisine of Jamaica. When a country's local cuisine has been influenced by a mess of different cultures, you're often left with a crazy selection of different foods that somehow all fuse together nicely. That's Jamaican cuisine in a nutshell, as you can go from enjoying something as spiced as curry-seasoned goat to sweeter tropical fruits like jackfruit. Early Spanish settlement introduced dishes like escovitch fish before Chinese influence crept in and introduced more Asian flavors. Some common cuisines to Jamaica include ackee and saltfish, jerk chicken, and corned beef. You may also come across Jamaican patties made from beef, chicken, or saltfish, rundown, or salt mackerel in coconut milk or cream, or a selection of bread and pastries like grater cake, spice bun, and bulla cakes. Number 8. Jamaican patois.
Wagwan, Jamaica!
No, it's not some delicious French dessert. Patois is actually the local dialect heard throughout Jamaica, also known locally as Jamaican Creole.
Everything in the house flood out. Don't me talk about everything. Everything. No bed, no dead for sleep on.
Derived from English, patois bears heavy influence from West Africa, especially from African slaves that were brought to Jamaica during the 17th century. Though you'll recognize some standard English words in patois, the language is vastly different, featuring only 21 phonemes compared to English's 44, and between 9 and 16 different vowel sounds. Also, unlike English, patois doesn't offer the benefit of tense indicators like ED, instead using invariant particles like EN and A, which are unable to stand on their own. While much of patois vocabulary is African in origin and some is pulled from English, small portions were borrowed from Spanish, Hindi, Arawak and Portuguese vocabulary, as well as Irish and Scottish dialects.
Everything gonna be Irish.
Number 7. Ahead of its time. For an island tucked in the midst of the Caribbean, it's quite an innovator, and not just regionally to the Caribbean either. Though some countries have been enjoying the benefits of a public railway transportation system for quite some time, in 1845, the British colony of Jamaica built the Railways of Jamaica, marking the first line opened outside of Europe and North America. Along with some of the other firsts that Jamaica achieved, it was the first country in the Caribbean to gain its independence, launch its own website, monitor literacy, and most importantly, become featured on Snapchat. It's also believed that Jamaica had running water and electricity before many cities in the United States, and had a series of phone lines so sophisticated that AT&T copied it for their own American setup. Number 6. Religion of Jamaica. Outside of Vatican City, Jamaica is known for having the most churches per square mile, typically averaging about 2.75 religious establishments to cater to the majority of Protestant and Roman Catholic Christians. The country is comprised of approximately 64% Christian followers, and while that far surpasses the 29,000-plus Rastafarians, Rastafarianism is the largest indigenous religion to Jamaica. Hidden beneath all of this religious faith, however, is the history of Obeah, a form of alleged sorcery and witchcraft initially developed by West African slaves. Obeah spread to Jamaica during the 18th century and wasn't really frowned upon until Tacky's War, during which an Obeah man, or Obeah witch doctor, was caught providing the rebels with information. Obeah was made illegal, and anyone caught practicing it would be jailed or flogged, although the archaic laws that limited practice of the voodoo-like religion were since repealed in 2013. Number 5. Port Royal. Depicted in the Pirates of the Caribbean series as a riotous and seemingly lawless place for the Caribbean's undesirables to converge, Port Royal was, well, exactly that. Nicknamed the most wicked and sinful city in the world, Port Royal was once a way station for pirates and the largest city in the Caribbean. Though it survived years of piracy, even serving as a place of execution for the brigands, it proved no match for Mother Nature. In June of 1692, after the city had experienced a growth in population and construction, an earthquake collapsed much of the northern section. A second destructive earthquake in January of 1907 demolished much of the rebuilt city, liquefying more of the unstable sand. Port Royal stands today as a redeveloped tourist attraction, complete with 17th century elements of the once bustling port. Number 4. Prehistoric people of Jamaica. Before pirates and slaves inhabited the lands of this Caribbean tropical beauty, Jamaica was home to a series of indigenous colonies dating as far back as 4000 BC. Long before the Arawakan people were known to inhabit the Caribbean island, Jamaica was occupied by the cave-dwelling Guanahatabe. The Guanahatabe, or Chiboni, were a Caribbean tribe believed to have stemmed from the Taino people and were inhabitants of western Cuba. At around 300 AD, Jamaica saw the arrival of a second group of prehistoric people, the Salidoid or Igneris. Later found to be an early wave of the Arawakan from South America, the Salidoids brought a skill for ceramics. By 650 AD, the Taino traveled from Venezuela to Jamaica and absorbed and enslaved the Salidoid before eventually assimilating into Arawakan culture themselves. Number 3. Jamaica in sports. We briefly mentioned Jamaica's claim to athletic fame, Usain Bolt, but there's more to the country's athletics than the award-winning sprinter. Many sports make up Jamaica's most popular, but among them, you'll likely hear most about track and field, football, cricket, and in most recent years, basketball. As 8-time Olympic gold medalist Bolt proved, the country is serious about its sprinting, but the Jamaican national football team has also proven to be a prolific team of athletes. In 1991, 1998, 2005, 2008, and 2010, Jamaica's football team won the Caribbean Cup. Also in 1998, they reigned over Japan in that year's FIFA World Cup. A bit more successful than its football team is the national cricket team, which has pulled ahead in 10 regional 4-day competitions and 7 WCB Cups. Maybe more surprising than all of this is the Jamaican bobsled team, which competed in the 1988, 1992, 1994, 1998, 2002, and 2014 Winter Olympics.
I'm just trying to be the best I can be.
So am I. And the best I can be is Jamaican.
Number 2. Jamaican World Records. As mentioned previously, Jamaica takes its sprinting seriously, which is why it currently holds the men's record for the 100, 150, and 200-meter dashes. Of course, that record goes to Usain Bolt, but he's far from the only impressive Jamaican out there. In fact, local Christopher Taylor took the 400-meter dash record for the under-18 boys age group, beating out 15-year-old Karani James's prior record by 0.01 seconds. Beyond sports, Jamaicans also hold the record for the most books donated to charity in a week, with over 65,700 books. In September of 2016, Isaiah Triforce Johnson broke the record for most wins against Tetrabot in Tetris Ultimate in a 24-hour time period, earning 614 wins. Number 1. Jamaican Independence. On August 6th of each year, Jamaica celebrates its own Independence Day. But an independence from whom, you ask? Prior to becoming its own sovereign state after a series of rebellions and the formation of the local political parties of the People's National Party and Jamaica Labor Party, the island was colonized by the British. Actually, the Spanish Empire took it first from the indigenous people, but after 146 years of Spanish rule, the British were sure to snatch it and add it to its collection of colonies. Ultimately, Jamaica owes its independence partially to World War II, which created the decolonization movement. In 1962, the Jamaica Independence Act was passed by the United Kingdom, though it remained within the Commonwealth.